Meghan steps back, Kate much steps up. Queen shut Harry's return door, patronages fall into Kate's hands. Prince Harry has passed the point of no return and will never return to the UK, a royal expert has claimed. Harry's exit from the royal family probably felt like an act of vandalism against the monarchy, an unearthed account claims. The Duke of Sussex has also suffered a psychological blow over losing his royal patronages, commentator Phil Dampier has said. With the Queen stripping Harry of his patronages of the Rugby Football Union, RFU, and Rugby Football League, RFL, Mr. Dampier claimed the Duke will be crushed by losing the cherished patronage. It is thought Kate, the Duchess of Cambridge, will now take up the roles which the commentator claimed shows how she is getting a greater role in the firm. Harry and Meghan announced last year that they would step back as senior members of the firm, a departure often dubbed Megxit. While the royal commentator claimed Harry will not return to the UK, he also added it is a great loss for the firm. Overall, Mr. Dampier insisted the upcoming move to hand Kate his rugby patronages shows a changing of the guard for the firm. He told The Sun Online, the handing over of the rugby patronage brings home that Kate is very much stepping up her royal duties and taking on more and more patronages and getting a higher profile. It also highlights the reality of Prince Harry being replaced in some of the things he enjoyed, but it's sad in that it's taking away the things he brought to the table. It's another example of the changing of the guard. It's a psychological blow as it emphasizes the split and it's very much final. The Queen had left the door open but it's past the point of no return, I can't see Harry coming him back to the UK, and so yes, it's another blow, and another example of what he has given up for his new life, and what it's cost him. I think Harry will be upset and will be miss being England's rugby patron. He's a big fan, and I'm sure that when the dust is settled and he's been out there for a couple of years, even though he's got projects he's working on, in time he will start to miss these things and miss his mates. But he can't really complain because he decided to quit the UK, he can't pick and choose the things he can do, he has made his bed and has to lie in it. Meghan and Harry have cited the pressure of being in the public eye and their associated mental health difficulties as reasons for them severing ties with the House of Windsor. The pair have since lifted the lid on life inside the firm in a number of high-profile interviews and media appearances. Harry was stripped of all his patronages when he and Meghan, Duchess of Sussex, moved to the US. Harry has been present at multiple games at Twickenham to watch England many times and was even seen celebrating the 2003 World Cup win in Australia with the squad. Harry has claimed that he feels sorry for his father, Prince Charles, the heir to the throne, and his brother Prince William, who he views as trapped in their lives of royal service. However, the Duke's family are unlikely to share his perspective on his newfound sense of freedom in America, according to a recently resurfaced interview with journalist and commentator. According to reports, Kate will take up the patronages in the coming months ahead of the lead-up to the Rugby League World Cup in October and November. Kate already holds patronages for Sports Aid, the All England Lawn Tennis and Croquet Club and the Lawn Tennis Association. As well as losing his rugby patronages, Harry also lost his military titles of Honorary Air Commandant at RAF Honington, Captain General of the Marines and Commodore and Chief of Small Ships and Diving. Meghan also lost patronages linked with the Queen's Commonwealth Trust, Royal National Theatre and the Association of Commonwealth Universities. After losing their patronages, the pair released a statement where they insisted service to the country will continue.